Okay, hi guys, how are you all doing? Welcome to Ignite India. I'll start the class. I'll share my screen and give feedback one by one. Please listen to it carefully. At the end in the group, I'll be sharing after this session finishes 4 to 5 textures, and that will be the homework as well. You will have a homework today. You will have a test tomorrow. Remember the timings. You will have to submit it during the time. And then Saturday, again, expert session by Gaurav and Ayan sir. They will give you feedback. Also, please be ready for this and wake up from your slumber time. We know now that I think Krishna sir, when he'll come in the end, he will inform you about the dates of situation test, which has been finalized. So kindly gear up, okay? Okay, so I'll be sharing my screen now and I will start showing the things which I have received. Okay, this is Neha. Neha, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. What's the theme and everything you need to explain? Looks like very basic work. There are 4 circles, maybe 5 pyramids. And 2 cubes. What's the theme?
So my theme was harmony.
Harmony. They're all of different colors. How is harmony coming?
No, it's green and yellow shades.
There is blue also. You can't see.
It's green. Something like blue.
Okay, this is green. This is blue. This is yellow. This is pale yellow. Harmony is of one color shade. Neha, one color and its shade, light green, dark green, maybe lime green, royal green.
Okay.
There should be some other theme to this. Either you say that it's a fun sculpture that I have created for kids and, you know, this is the headgear which I want to show. But we can't keep it like, अरे question में बोला है, geometric shape से headgear बनाना है, तो बस 5 geometric shape बनाया और उससे headgear बना दिया. ऐसे तो फिर 50-60 मार्क्स ही आएंगे 100 में से. दिस कैन बी डन बाय एनीवन, राइट? व्हाट आई एम ट्राइंग टू से इज इट कैन बी डन बाय एनीवन. देयर इज नथिंग क्रिएटिव. अब वो सारे क्यूबॉइड्स में देयर इज नो डिफरेंट टेक्सचर. क्विलिंग तो हुई नहीं है उस क्यूबॉइड्स पे. उस सर्कल के ऊपर तुमने कुछ कार्व करके तो लगाया नहीं है. देयर आर नो टेक्सचर्स. कहीं मुझे फ्रिंजिंग नहीं दिख रही, कहीं कुछ भी नहीं दिख रहा. तुमने सिर्फ ज्योमेट्रिक शेप्स बना के यू अटैच देम इन अ फॉर्म एंड यू हैव पुट इट. सो ट्राई टू एलिवेट दिस अप नाउ. दिस इज अ बेसिक आइडियल शेप व्हिच यू हैव क्रिएटेड. दिस इज अ फॉर्म. नाउ यू नीड टू वर्क ऑन इट बाय एडिंग मोर टेक्सचर्स एंड डिटेलिंग टू इट. ओके, एंड ट्राई टू कीप द कलर सेम. अगर ग्रीन है तो उस पर ग्रीन कलर से टेक्सचर करो. ब्लू है, ब्लू कलर से टेक्सचर करो. देन इट विल लुक गुड. आई रिक्वेस्ट एवरीवन टू म्यूट देमसेल्व्स इफ यू आर नॉट. For everyone who is in the group right now, I won't be admitting anyone post 5 minutes of the class session. This is the last time I am telling and I am repeating myself. Thank you. Gyanvi, hi, I know you were not well. Are you here?
Yeah, Gyanvi was having exams. She was well. She was having exams.
Okay, Gyanvi, are you here? I can see you, but you need to unmute yourself.
Yeah, I'm here.
Okay. So the geometric shape concept. Try to, Gyanvi, add more textures to it. Okay.
Yeah, I'll do it. I actually have very little time, so just
no
did,
problem.
You know,
take
half an hour.
Today, one hour. Take yeah. 1 hour. Sit with it and give it lot of textures, okay. Like you have done for your slippers and footwear. Okay, try to add yeah. textures to it. Okay,
I'll do that.
Okay. Chandrika, this is you, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, what's the theme?
I took geometrical shape. I made only from triangles.
Okay, so that is the question that I gave. Make a headgear from geometric shape. What is the theme?
Okay. I just made for a runway.
Fashion runway show.
Yeah.
So then you need to say it, that I have made a headgear for a fashion runway show. It's made from triangles. I have used aluminium foil. I have used paper craft. Try to use these kind of words when you speak, because that's what you will add in your write-up. Otherwise, it's just a headgear, right? So try to add these things, and I need to see more pictures of this and more detailing. I need more views, front view, side view, top view.
Can I show now?
You can show now. Are you there? Yes, I can see you. Okay, yeah, I can understand, but I need clear pictures in white background of this and a clear concept drawing and a sketch. Okay, we do not start making anything without a sketch. Okay, this is Tejaswini. Tejaswini, are you here? Tejaswini, are you here? You need to unmute yourself if you are here to speak.
Yes, ma'am, I'm here.
Okay, can you explain your model, please?
Yeah, so I've made a model. I made a headgear as using geometrical shapes. So I've given the theme as bloggers, best travel bloggers, crown for best travel blogger for International Bloggers Award of 2019. That is what I've written.
Okay.
So I've used geometrical shapes. So I made up. I've used only pastel sheets and nothing else. Thick pastel sheets and this crepe paper. That's it.
Okay.
So.
So the color and all, everything is fine. Your concept is also good. But what is happening here? What's a pyramid?
Yeah, I wasn't able to, give the finishing properly. I don't know, it happens with me in every model. So the finishing always...
That you get, you need to take time and be calm and be patient and do it, okay? Because your concepts are good, but the finishing has to be done. This is very rough work which is happening here. That's why I tell you to make your elements separately and then try to stick it on the base. The base and everything is fine. Your concept also I understand, but try to make it much more neater. You need to join the pyramids. You need to, don't bombard your headgear with lot of elements that you are unable to make on time. So make first your elements, complete them. You can stick the pyramids in, big to small way, like in a balanced way in the front, and then add the Taj Mahal in the center. So try to work on this piece and finish.
Okay.
The rest, everything is good. Let's move on to Janvi's. I saw Anurag. Are you here?
Yeah.
I am sorry if it feels a little rude from my side, but I try to tell you something over and over 2 to 3 times and you still neglect it. So as I told you in the written text also, this looks really simple. There are just 4 feathers which are attached to it. I would like you to add more color to it, more depth to it, because the base is fine.
I don't have a material with me right now. I have like
Okay, then do it from newspaper. Do you have newspaper?
Okay, yeah.
But I need to see depth in this. This is a very basic, rough model. You cannot work like this in test or with experts, because my teaching is also at stake. Those people are coming to see what I am teaching at the end. The evaluation is happening for me also, like it's happening for you. So try to do work which can be presented well as well. So if you are using just white paper, at least add 10 feathers to it. At least, give it some depth or volume, because this doesn't look like a fair work at all. And I told you this in group also, that you need to add more things in your sketch. Front view, side view, you need to add the hangings if you had. It needs to be separate. Plus, try to take pictures in a better way. And you can see the work of other students in the group. They are your competitors. Try to match it up or try to lift it up, because you have that much of skill and I don't know what's keeping you back. So please work on this. Next is, one second, Pramod. Okay. Pramod, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, Pramod, the form is good. The skill is good. You have used textures very well. Can you explain your model to me?
So, this is a headgear based on the geometrical shape. So, I took inspiration from an emperor's headgear and I just made it for a fashion walk.
Okay. Good. I just want to see that this thing that is on the nose, try to make it a little thicker. Maybe you don't have that paper.
Yeah.
Try
yeah,
to add that. And on these triangles which are coming out, try to put texture on it, the things that are coming out.
Okay.
Okay. Good.
Okay.
Let's move on to this. Krishna.
Yes, ma'am.
Very good work. Good skill. I can see you have used the textures very creatively. The form is good. Can you explain?
Yes. So I have made a headgear for a queen to use. Like the theme is ancestry. And I have used the geometrical shapes, mostly like pentagons, square, circle. And the front part is the extension till the nose, eyes, and ears. So, and even there, I've given the fringing technique. So it looks like a hair-like finish. And in the upper part, I've used the kirigami, like the waist black paper. I've used in the borders and quilling also in the front with orange stripes.
Good work. Overall, the product looks really good. Use of color is good. I can see in the front there's a different look. In the side it looks different. From the back also it's different, and you have given it a good volume and height. Try to see if it can stand, you know, like it shouldn't tear if someone's trying to pick it up, or you know, it can stand properly. Okay. Rest everything is fine. Yeah. Good work.
Okay.
Good work.
Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
You're welcome. Ria. Ria, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Are these the only two pictures you have sent me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so I can see you have used it. Can you explain it to me?
So, ma'am, I made a tiara, and my concept is just, it's very simple. It's just snow and ice. So what I've done is, so usually I use a lot of paper. So this time I thought I'll use more of foil. Because I thought, since it's a tiara, and usually tiaras are worn like this, so the foil would help fit and provide, make sure that it doesn't fall. So okay. Over here, it's basically supposed to show the beauty of, you know, the forms that ice makes.
Okay.
So you have snowflakes. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Good. How much time did it take you? Because I know I removed the limit to submit the homework this time.
It took me 1.5 hours.
Yeah, because I know this kind of kirigami will take a lot of time to do. You have to cut each shape and then do it.
Yeah, the snowflakes, you make a circle. So it's actually easy if you just...
Okay, fold it and then cut it.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, that's what I do, yeah.
Okay, good. I don't know if, you know, using some other material would make it look a little bit, you know, much more neater. I don't know. It was a thin paper maybe, so it's flying. But the concept is good. I just feel in wise of volume to the thing, you could have done better. But if it's tiara, then it's fine. Tiaras are supposed to be like this only. And this technique that you have done here where using an aluminium foil, you have put the paper inside it. So it's good. It's a new technique and I'm happy you've explored it.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good. Deep Panchika, are you here?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, can you explain?
Yes, ma'am. So this is a headgear inspired by birds, which can be worn in parties and particularly fests, because when we see fests are something like very colorful and, you know, people go out of the box and you get to see many stuff there. So I added here a lot of color, so you know, to show the livelihood of a fest. And since we had a question to get inspired by birds, hence it has a touch of birds and more colors, as in for parties and fests. I've used this is mostly not more, yeah, it's almost made up of made by using the method layering. As you can see, even in the feathers, I've used layer, and even on the body of the bird, the texture which I've created, it is again by layering. So every time I have layered with one piece.
Okay. Good. I know this would have taken time. How much time it took?
It actually took me nearly like 1.5 or 1 hour 45 minutes.
Yeah, okay.
Because I have to
stay 1 month. So, Deepa, the concept is good. If you took the second question, which was the bird one, it has come out well. If it's for a fashion show or a costume party, it's good. Just that the base, when you are keeping it, it's a little unstable, maybe, or you have folded it in that way. So it's fine.
I folded it in that way.
Yeah, I would have expected that this layering that you have done with feathers, try to fringe it on the side, like how a bird feather is.
Okay.
Only on the pink one outside. It will look good. Okay.
I will do that.
Yeah. Rest, if this feathers on the blue or this metal texture that you have, paper you have used, it's fine. And your strips, try to be a little neater next time. That's it. Maybe I'm zooming in pictures so I can see those details.
No, actually the thing is these fluorescent sheets are like one side white in color and other side the colored one.
Yeah.
So when we cut,
it
we can see the white line.
Okay, yeah. Okay. But overall, good. Good work.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah. This is Anna. Anna?
Yes, ma'am.
Are you here?
Yes.
Okay, can you explain me?
Like, I've just made a headgear that we can use in fashion rams and like in a costume party. So like, I've used kirigami a lot from circles.
Anna, what's
and
the
diamonds.
Geometric or bird? The question was geometric.
Geometric, geometric.
Okay.
Geometric.
Okay.
But then the white paper I had were like a bit like crushed or something. So like, it is not as neat as I want it to be. You know, okay. The one on the top and all, like, it's not
okay.
That.
So, Anna, your concept is very good. The skills that you have used is very good. It's just that you didn't have the right paper for this. See, the black paper is
Very
thin. If you use a thicker paper, I know it would come out really good. The rolling, the kirigami, the crumpling of paper, the fringing, the quilling, even here, how you have taken out the orange things has come out very well. Try to find a thick sheet if you can. Otherwise, this, when done with a thicker sheet of paper, would look completely fine. Good. Even the colors are good for this.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good. Let's move on to Surbhi. Surbhi, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, where are you? I can't see you. Okay, yes. Surbhi, can you explain me? You
so,
made one
ma'am.
This also and one this also. Explain.
Ma'am, I have designed a headgear with inspired by Adivasi people.
So, okay.
It's just done by cutting and folding method and yeah.
That's it. Tomorrow after the test when experts will ask you, you will say just like this. Give me one more line of explanation. Tell me about the color and the shape of it.
Ma'am, its shape is a little bit like diamond shape, I think so.
Yes, so the shape is diamond, conical on the top. You have tried to give it a look of those old Adivasi people who used to wear this, that tribe. It's a tribal look. It's only one thing, Surbhi, you need to finish it. This is not finished product. This is an unfinished headgear. Okay, you need to add textures.
Okay.
The base needs to be designed properly. Even on this cones that you have done, try to add more things because the basic form has come out really good. Try to complete this, okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. Let's move to next. Harshini, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, one second. Yes. Can you explain your model?
Yes, ma'am. So I took inspiration from bird and mainly the origami designed bird, and I made it using made the triangle from as 3D so that it stands on your head and it does not fall. And using that as a base structure, I stuck and cut the paper and made it like a bird.
Okay.
And I used Chinese folding for the feathers and some toothpick with some thermocol balls.
Good. Your color composition is very good. You have taken inspiration from bird. The form is good. The flowers are good. The thermocol lining, the Chinese folding, I can see these kind of textures. So guys, try to incorporate the texture techniques that we have taught you. Marks is not on just using one technique and finishing the headgear. Marks is on how variety you can show, how much variety you can show in your product. So try to show this, but the form and everything is good. Harshini, overall great job. Okay.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Neha again.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you explain, please?
Yeah, I made a headgear inspired from bird and I've combined it with Egyptian headgears and I've used those colors.
Which bird is it?
Peacock.
Peacock? Is a peacock yellow?
No, ma'am. The feathers.
Okay, so the feathers are purple and in middle you have used yellow.
It's a combination of Egyptian headgears and peacock.
Okay, but let me be very clear, Neha. This looks like Egyptian. It doesn't look like a peacock.
Okay.
Peacock, we all know the colors of peacock. Blue, green, that's it. So if it's purple and it's yellow and red and brown, it's an Egyptian headgear. It doesn't come under, and this is more of your geometric patterns than a bird, which is flowy, feathery, you know, which has a lot of feathers or a lot of things. So try to see what you are making. There is something that is in our head that, oh, I'm trying to achieve this thing. But if some things come out to be like this, then we change our concept. It's simple. I've always told you, changes happen in design when we work. It always happens. A product will change. So it's okay. You just change your brief. It's simple. Okay. But this looks good. This looks more like an Egyptian or a tribal kind of a feel. So try to relate it that. Just see these corners and all. I want them proper.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay. And all these things on the top, if they are not equal, try to at least cut them properly. Okay. Even here, your squares.
Yeah.
And much more neater, okay?
Yes, ma'am.
This is Yashasvi. Yashasvi, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, explain.
And I made a headgear, tribal headgear with twisting crepe paper.
Okay.
And making textures in leaf.
Okay.
And I also made one more headgear.
Yes, by origami.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, good. So this Egyptian tribal one which you have made is good, Yashasvi. Color combinations are good. You have tried to use these leaves in origami form, which is good. And this crumpling rolling is also good. This one is fine. But you need to complete this other origami one. It is very basic shape. Try to complete this purple one. Okay? The rest one is good. This is your sister.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yeah, so try to give this a better look, okay? Like add more textures on it.
Okay.
Good. Next is, who is this person? Okay, this is, I think, Varshita, are you here? Varshita?
Yeah.
Okay.
I added textures.
I know you added textures. I just want you to explain things.
Yeah. I've made a clear one, yeah. The last one.
This is Rachel, okay.
This one.
Yes.
Yeah, so this is from the topic geometric shapes. I got inspired from the geometric shape. And I used foil to give some texture and luster.
Okay.
And I crumpled the foil more so that it's more sharp and brighter. And I used an eyebrow for my right eye using foil. And I made some design. And again, I added straws. This one. Yeah.
Good. Good.
I added a texture.
Your shape is very innovative and it's very new. And it's, I think the shape out of everyone who has done, it's the best shape that you have come out with. You have done folding. The textures, I know on black, you only used aluminium foil. Just try to make this side a little bit more neater. You know, randomly pasting it, try to keep it in balance.
Okay.
Okay.
Ma'am, I just added foil on the straw also. Is it fine?
I cannot see.
It's in my video.
I don't know what is happening. Who is doing annotations to my screen? Okay, one second.
Yeah.
Can I see your work? Okay, yes, I can see.
I added aluminium balls on the straw also. Is it fine?
This is fine. Good, good. As your theme and as your concept, it's fine. The shape is also good. Try to just balance it on one side and other side. If you have made it half-half, then do half-half. Okay? But it's good. Share screen again. Okay, next is... Okay, Rachel, are you here?
Yes, ma'am, I'm here.
Guys, I hope you see this. Great skill and very good work.
Thank you, ma'am.
Good. Can you explain it?
Yeah, sure. So I have my model with me. So what I have done here is I've taken inspiration from, it's an Egyptian headgear. I've taken inspiration from Turkey the bird. So okay. For the top part, I've used the feathers of a turkey. It looks very like circular in shape. So I've taken that as an inspiration.
Okay.
And then Queen Nefertiti, which is an Egyptian queen, she had a very similar shaped headgear on her head. So I've taken that as an inspiration. And the Tomb of Tutankhamun, he had these something similar on his coffin tomb. So I've taken that as inspiration as well. And I've just used kirigami over here. And
yeah, origami, kirigami, fringing. I can see all of that.
Yeah.
Very good and very neat work. Good.
Thank you,
guys. This is how you make a headgear. It should fit on your head. It should have volume, depth, texture, and there should be a theme. You should know the concept you are taking inspiration from. It shouldn't be just like randomly an idea came and you did it. Like, try to take an inspiration and justify it. Very good work, Rachel.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay, let's move on to Aparna. Aparna, are you here?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay,
yeah,
the form of this. Can you explain it?
Yeah, so I had made a hair brooch, which was inspired from like colorful feathers for parrot. So
okay.
I had made this for like a runway itself. And so I have used like a lot of fringing on the feathers and rolling techniques and then the displaying the, putting up the strips on the surface and sticking it.
Okay.
And it's just like a side hair brush for the hair.
Good. I like your things. The only thing I told you in group also that it can be a little bit neater. You know, the color palette is fine. Try to keep it a little bit Shivani, what happened to you? I'll show your face. I'm sorry. You are sending me chats on the group. But Aparna, yeah, back to you. Try to be it more neater, but the idea is good. The shape and the form on the side of the head is good.
Okay.
And the sketch, this is how I want the sketches to be. So kindly send me the sketches. Shivani, are you here?
Thank you.
Yeah, ma'am, don't show my face. Okay,
I'm not showing your face. You just explain me this.
Yeah, so I think it's a very basic design compared to others.
Thank you. Yes. Next.
Yeah. I know. And like, but I've seen these types of headgears in like Ferragamo runways or like Ford Military. But I was inspired by that also. And then like it's a Persian type cap. Like you've seen them wearing that.
Yeah.
With intricate patterns. Yeah, so, and the color white and blue, like in most of Turkey and Istanbul, their structures are made up mainly of blue and white, like the dark blue and white. I didn't have dark blue, so I did it with this.
Okay.
And it's a, like the weaving type thing, I just had to stick the straps.
Okay.
And give it like the top view, like at the back, those crisscross patterns.
Okay, good. Okay, yeah, so that basic form is good. Shivani is just simple for me. Like, you know, I understand
your concept,
and if it's simple, it's fine. But you know, in a competitive exam, you are judged on how others work. So imagine I ask you to make a cube and everyone makes a cube, but one of them makes a Rubik cube. So it's obvious that I will give him more marks, even if it was not asked. So in art and craft or in design competitive exams, try to, you know, work according to how others are evolving or developing, because that will help you. Okay. But the basis and your concept, it's completely fine. There's no thing. I just wanted you to do more, maybe because I was seeing a lot of work others were doing. Okay.
Yeah.
Try to take another theme and make another one. That would help.
Yeah.
Okay. Who else? This is for Shivani's only. Okay, so have I mentioned everyone's work or anyone who has not shown me? I don't think I've checked everyone's. Aparna, Neha, Ria, Pramod, Deep, Anurag, Yanvi, Rachel. Good, everyone worked. I'm very happy. So guys, again, things that you should look out for, make the concept first. Concept is based on the inspiration you take. Suppose yesterday I watched that movie of Elizabeth, which won Oscars, and I really like her crown. So, you know, there's an inspiration, which is I am taking and taking it forward. Or, you know, I'm taking an inspiration from tiaras and then moving forward. So that has to be kept in mind. Secondly, try to be neater, which is like at the end, after your thing is made, try to finish it with scissor. Try to finish, rub the Fevicol. If there is, you know, Fevicol has dried and marks are there, rub it up. Thirdly, I would say is make sure it stands and it has volume. You saw Rachel's one, Shivani's one, Deepanshika's one, Anna's or Aparna's or Varshita's or Ria's. Try to keep it on your head, or you know, Yasha squeeze, keep it on head, see how it looks like. Okay, and you know, get it checked. You have so many family members at home now. I'm sure they're not doing anything. Give it to them. How does it look like? Do you want me to add something to this? Will you buy this from me if I sell it to you? So, you know, try to understand your consumer also, because this is a design exam. No art. This is not an art and craft classes. This is a design exam. So move towards that direction. Secondly, I'll post a homework. Your homework is simple. Please redo the things I have told you and be prepared for tomorrow. Tomorrow there will be a test. Try to be awake at 12 p.m. and keep your materials ready. I'll use only materials that you have been taught, paper, soap, clay. I'll give you a question, post it within the time and learn from your last expert session. Okay? Make it concept oriented. Make it neat. Try to not Google or Pinterest from anything. We have seen few things we have saw in Pinterest, and me and Gaurav or Ayan has talked also within us that we have seen these things on Pinterest, or we also see Instagram. So be original. Okay? I'll see you tomorrow after tests, maybe day after now. Okay?
Ma'am, Deepanshika here, just one thing. Actually, I didn't attend the write-up wala class. So this time I have written like according to the format you have given. So can you just go through my write-up just review?
I will. I'll go through everyone's write-up and review. Okay? Because this session is about to end. Okay, guys?
Yes.
Krishna sir, we have 1 minute. I think he's not here. Okay. Guys, bye. See you. Bye.
Bye.
And
bye.
Pearl guys, 6 p.m. In 15 minutes, I want to see you. Bye.